just got an Amazon delivery and I got the L'Oreal True Match Foundation just because I think this is one of the OG cult favorite drugstore foundations and it was only $5, so I might as well try it because I've been on the hunt for the perfect, affordable, long-lasting, natural finish foundation for years. And I also got a new tripod, which I'm super excited about. I also got a package from Crave Beauty and I got 4 of their Great Barrier Relief Serums because they were having a 50% off warehouse sale since they are switching up their packaging for it to become more sustainable, which is really, really amazing. But yeah, I got these just because this has been one of my holy grail serums for the past 1 year, 1 to 2 years actually. Every time I use this serum, my skin just feels so moisturized in the morning and it's not overly oily, even though the main star ingredient is Tamanu oil. I am just at my parents' cafe and just helping them out a little bit. Just made a honey green tea with boba. So it's the next day and I just finished getting ready and I used the new foundation and I am just so shocked by this $5 foundation. My skin looks super smooth and porcelain-like and I'm just in disbelief because I just got a Lancome foundation for about $35 and I honestly think this L'Oreal one is better. I definitely do have to see how well it holds up throughout the day because my problem is that usually all foundations go really well on my skin and they look really, really nice for the first hour or two, but then at the end of the day it just looks really flaky and my skin's oily and yeah. Well, I just realized that Lancome is actually owned by L'Oreal, which makes a lot of sense. This is the master's bedroom with a private bathroom and another bedroom. And then here's a little nook. We're using a carpet as a blanket. Having some dim sum for dinner. Got some apple pie.
Oops. Hi. Hey, Yuki.
And blueberry. Later than I usually do. So a problem I have as a very goal-oriented person is that it's hard for me to feel content at where I am in life. And even when I'm not necessarily working on something urgent, if it's on my schedule, I always feel compelled to do it and I won't feel productive or satisfied with the day unless it's off my list. And because of that, whenever I'm behind on schedule, I tend to not really prioritize my self-care or eating a good meal. I would just whip up whatever I can that's in the kitchen, even if it's not the best for me. However, I have realized that because I'm always trying to aim for that next goal, that next step in my life, I really have to slow down, because if my mindset is always constantly working on the next thing, I'm really never able to focus on what's going on in front of me and I guess just enjoy life.
This is where we are going to edit everything.
My new MacBook Air 13-inch just came in the mail and I'm so excited to finally receive this new laptop, because my old MacBook Pro has been very, very used up. The battery almost never holds a charge unless I have it plugged in all the time, and also the speakers were broken, and so I thought it'd be a better investment if I just got a new laptop rather than spend a few hundred dollars repairing the battery and the speakers. So I think a struggle that many small business owners have is how much to pay themselves, how frequently, and also when they can treat themselves to something nice. Because as a small business owner, you are constantly, you know, reinvesting your profits into the business, such as inventory and such, and how to scale your business. And so sometimes it's really, really hard to know, you know, if you should spend money on something or not. However, I do think that when it comes to tech products that can, you know, improve your efficiency and productivity and just make your life a whole lot easier, I just think it's a really, really good investment and oftentimes very well needed. I was going to get the MacBook Pro, the 14-inch one, but I decided to get the MacBook Air just because it's still better than my current MacBook Pro, which is all the way from mid-2014. I'm really excited because this one is 16GB RAM instead of my current one, which is 8GB, so I'm able to run a lot more softwares at once, which is super, super crucial when it comes to meetings and collaborating on projects. So because it only has the two USB-C ports, I had to get an adapter. Also got some webcam covers, of course, and a laptop stand, so it's more convenient for me to have that dual screen setup with my external monitor. I'm so sad, they gave me the wrong color. Yeah.